New Brunswick is cracking down on immunizations in the wake of a measles outbreak. The provincial government has tabled legislation to make immunizations mandatory for students, and the only acceptable reason for an exemption would be a medical one. That means parents who won't vaccinate their kids for personal reasons would not be able to send their kids to public school. In St. John, 12 cases of measles have been confirmed, and in Fredericton, there have been 28 cases of whooping cough. Dominic Cardy is New Brunswick's Minister of Education and Early Childhood Development. He joins us now from Fredericton. Hi, Minister. Nice to see you.
Hi. Good evening, Vashi. Thanks for having me on the show.
So you've introduced legislative amendments that would make it so that the only acceptable reason for kids not to be immunized is essentially medical. Why did you take this kind of a step?
Well, I think we've seen a disturbing rise in the recent decades in sentiment against vaccination based on a huge amount of misinformation, often quite dangerous misinformation, that's led to people questioning the effectiveness and safety of our vaccine regime in Canada. And I think that regime is one of the most significant blessings that our culture has really produced over the course of the last couple of hundred years. It's a gift that saved hundreds of millions of lives around the world. And I think it would be terrible if we saw support for vaccines erode in places like Canada. And I think we have got to make it very clear that when it comes to public schools, that public safety has to come first. And that means that children shouldn't be able to come to school with a potentially fatal disease that could especially harm other children, whether they're healthy, in which case they could take a disease like measles. 1 to 2 out of every 1,000 cases could result in death. And then you've also got a very small percentage of the population who really can't get vaccinated. And we've got to make sure that we have everyone around those kids vaccinated to protect them. So there are kids going through cancer treatment. I've heard some real horror stories from parents the last couple of weeks since I've been talking about this issue, raising the fact that, you know, their kids are deprived from going to school and deprived of having a normal life because there are people around who are, I would argue, being insensitive and not being good citizens by refusing to have their kids vaccinated for reasons that are entirely foolish. And I think we've got to start a conversation in Canada and across the world around the vast majority of moderate people saying, look, the stuff around vaccines, the questioning of the safety and effectiveness of vaccines, it's got to stop. Vaccines save hundreds of millions of lives, and I think that people in positions of responsibility, such as the one that I'm honored to have, we've got to be front and center at that discussion and not shy away from it.
Were there kids showing up in schools across your province without being vaccinated? Like, are you tracking that? What sort of evidence prompted you to take this step?
Well, what prompted it was the fact that we had in New Brunswick a requirement that kids provide proof of vaccination when they entered the school system unless they had an exemption, and the exemption criteria was very broad. But even that basic level of information wasn't being collected. And there just seems to be a real shying away from being willing to talk about and confront the problem of what was often called vaccine hesitancy, and often popularly called the anti-vaxxer movement. And so absolutely, there have been kids in New Brunswick who have come to school without their proper vaccines. And I know that for most parents, it's often a question of if the school isn't demanding it, they're busy and they've got 3,000 other things to do. So we've got to make sure that we can make it as easy as possible for kids to get vaccinated. That's why we're making sure we take the time to set this program up right. But at the end of the day, we don't let kids go to school with peanut butter. If there's a kid in class who's allergic to peanut butter, I think it's equally as irresponsible for folks to come in who may be carrying a potentially fatal disease that could have serious health impacts on the other people in their class. Again, it's about being a good citizen, using the science that we have to protect our kids.
Will there be penalties if a kid comes to school and doesn't get vaccinated?
If they don't have a medical exemption, they would be excluded from public school. They would have the options for homeschooling, so that's always going to be there, and we're not taking away the right of parents to decide what they believe is in best interest of their children. But we are saying that just as over the decades there have been other restrictions on personal freedoms to make sure that the public safety is preserved, and seatbelt laws, helmet laws, and others, drunk driving laws. I would put this in the same category, that we don't let people drive drunk because it endangers others. Not being vaccinated also endangers others. So the costs of being vaccinated are essentially zero. That the information that circulates out there on the internet from all sorts of spurious sources that comes from various disreputable, discredited former doctors and so on, we've got to stand up and say, this isn't true, it's not real, the science is in on vaccines, and we have got to make sure the vaccine regime is enforced, because otherwise we are putting the lives of vulnerable New Brunswickers and Canadians at risk, and that's not something I feel would be responsible in my position as minister.
Do you think other provinces should follow suit, and do you have any expectations or hopes for action from the federal government? If so, what kind?
No, I'm hopeful that my colleagues in other provinces might look with interest in what we're trying here in New Brunswick, and I certainly hope they do follow along, because this is a growing problem across Canada and around the Western world, the rise of this anti-vaccination movement. And we've got to start seeing politicians having the courage to stand up and saying, we are not going to put up with this anymore. We're going to talk about facts, defend the facts, and get out there and make sure that we've got an excellent public health care system supporting a world-class education system. So we've got to start defending our institutions again, because if we don't, we've seen what happens around the world right now. When institutions aren't defended, they erode and start to crumble away. And to me, the vaccine regime is part of that, and it's an important part because it affects the safety of our children. And if the safety of our children isn't important, then I don't really know what would be.
There has been a lot of talk lately, of course, as you rightly point out, about the anti-vaxxer movement. There is sort of a discussion that's taking place about how you combat that. I remember interviewing Dr. Tan, the chief public health officer here in Canada, and she's saying, you know, you got to sort of strike where they are, get online and do more in that arena. Do you think, I mean, by introducing legislation, are you sending the message that that won't be enough? Do you think legislative solutions are going to be what's necessary?
I believe they are. Otherwise, I wouldn't have suggested and proposed the amendments that I did today to New Brunswick's Health and Education and other acts. So I think it's absolutely the case, and I would encourage people that when you see people spreading misinformation, don't just believe it. Go and seek out credible, reputable scientific sources and recognize the importance of those sources. And pushback, absolutely. And I've been pleased that since I talked about this online, I've seen lots of people pushing back against the anti-vaccination folks and saying, look, what you're doing here is really no different than child abuse. That if your child does not have a medical reason to be exempt from vaccinations, you're putting your child and others at risk. And I cannot believe that most parents, or hardly any parents, would actually choose to do that voluntarily. So it comes a question of being convincing in the way we put the information across, but also taking a clear stand, in this case as a province. And I'd argue it should be done by other provinces and the federal government. If they wanted to get on board, that would be fantastic, to stand up and say, the vaccine regime that we have has saved millions and millions of lives. And it's doing that right now. And the last thing we want is to start going backwards. So let's defend the regime. Let's make sure that the science is clearly explained. It's not about being condescending to people and saying that they don't know what's going on. It's about making sure that the facts are readily available, engaging people in discussion, but at the end also taking action, which is what government's job is supposed to be. And that's why our government's taking action here in New Brunswick, to make sure we can protect our kids, recognize the science, and hopefully defend something that's a pretty critical part of our institution as a province and as a country.
All right. Thank you so much, Minister Carty. That's Dominic Carty, New Brunswick's Minister of Education and Early Childhood Development.
Thanks, Vashi.
Hi, I'm Vashi Capellos, host of Power in Politics. See more of our show by subscribing to the CBC News channel or click the link for another video. Thanks for watching.